welcome back. At just 17 years of age, she set the record as the youngest female to top the Billboard charts. Now, former teen idol Tiffany is bringing her greatest hits back to Australia. The sun still shines, the sun still sets,
and the heart forgives, the heart forgets. Oh, such a flashback we're going through here. Tiffany is with us in the studio while we go through her songs. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
And welcome to the show.
Well, thank you.
Sorry we're dressed up and you're not, but it is.
I know, but I said at least I'm color coordinated with you.
You
I didn't get the memo that we were doing fabulous, but it is a fabulous day, isn't it?
It is a fabulous day. Happy Oscars Day.
And everybody in LA.
And welcome back to Australia, because how long has it been since you were here last?
I've never been here.
You've never been here?
No, isn't that
crazy? I thought you came
like
at that first time in the 80s.
No, I've never been. So it's 30 years in the making, and I'm so excited to be here now, and I'm coming right back.
Yeah.
You know, everybody goes, it's so far on the plane ride, but I have new music out, Pieces of Me, everybody, new album, and you can go to tiffanytunes.com and check it out. So I want to bring my band back.
Yes.
And, of course, I'll always do the retro stuff. I think Willow Now Could Have Been. They're my hits. I love them. But I want to show off my new stuff as well.
Maybe that's why we feel like you've been here before, because your music for a lot of people in Australia, it was you know, everything. It was everywhere. I Think We're Alone Now was massive.
And you dominated like smash hits and all the magazines, TV hits.
Like, so there's no reason not to come here. I don't know what happened, but I'm here now. You got me back, and I'm so excited. The fans have been so wonderful.
Tiffany, we saw that you posted a throwback with Michael Jackson a few days ago.
Yes.
Were you close with the King of Pop?
Well, I had knocked his single Bad off of the number one spot.
Yeah.
And then I got to meet him a week later, which I was so nervous. And he was lovely. You know, I was in the circle of friends, but no, I didn't spend a lot of time with Michael Jackson. But he definitely was like, took his time to talk to me. There was a huge queue of people and all his fans. And I'm backing away because I didn't want to take too much time.
Yeah.
I didn't get the whole star thing at the time, you know, especially for myself. And so I just was gracious to meet him. But, you know, he said the two things. Are you having fun, and keep good people around you?
Yeah.
And that has kind of been my model. Thank you, Michael, forever.
Just while we're on the topic of Michael Jackson, because there was a 60 Minute story last night.
Right.
There's a new documentary that's coming out, and there are several allegations leveled at him in that. What are your thoughts?
It's heartbreaking, isn't it, really? I mean, I think some things are really pointing to certain things that are a little ugly. Well, very ugly. And it's kind of hard to overlook some of that. But I do think that no matter what, he is the King of Pop. And musically, he reigns and rules.
So you think you can disassociate the art from the man?
I try to myself. I really do. Because for music, as a legend, he is a legend in music. And you wouldn't have a lot of the artists that you have today if it wasn't for Michael Jackson. So out of that, of course, as a musician, I respect him.
A bit of a change of course here. I wanted to ask you about this because when I found out you were coming in, I forgot how much I loved you at the time. And, you know, we all my mates and stuff, we loved you. We loved the songs and stuff. We used to dance to you at our parties. But also, I want to know how you felt about this single by Weird Al Yankovic.
I think I'm a clone now.
I think I'm a clone now.
I know it very well.
But I wondered at the time, because obviously, with it was fat. He'd just come off Fat, Like a Surgeon, and then he did I Think I'm a Clone Now. And I thought, okay, those other two were well-established pop stars, and you were a new artist. Was that, like, flattery for you, or was that like, oh, hang on a second, I'm just getting into this game?
Well, I have a wicked sense of humor, first of all, so I thought it was hysterically funny. I took it as a compliment.
Well, you should, because you're amazing, and we're so glad to have you in the studio today, Tiffany. For details, head to frontiertouring.com.au. Make sure you go and see Tiffany performing around Australia. Thanks so much.
I'll see you when you come back.
Thank you, guys. Thanks.